How's it going, everybody? It's C-RadTV back here in our video. So, of course, I got a few NASCAR diecasts that have come in the mail the other day. It's been a little bit since we last did a diecast unboxing, so we're going to go ahead and we're going to open these diecasts up. We got three of them here, including one of them being the Phoenix Race Win Championship diecast. So, we're going to do that one last, but we're going to do the other two first. Because one of them is the Bowman one and the other is the Noah Gregson one. So let's go ahead and let's take a look at the Bowman one first. So, since they just ship them in the box like this, this one's pretty open, easy to open. And there we go, right there. And now to unwrap it. Just like so. And throw that in the trash, and there it is. The Alex Bowman Martinsville Race Win Diecast. So for this, they made 840 of these. So there is a decent amount of these available. But now it's opening up. Okay, this will need these two things we don't need. I missed the trash can. But we do need the winner sticker right there. Put that to the side. Box to the side. So yeah, here's the Alex Bowman hero card right here. And everything you need to know about the race on the back right there. But now here is the diecast. And voila. So yeah, very nice looking diecast here. They actually don't have that much front end damage from when Denny Hamlin tried to prevent Bowman from doing his burnout and backing him up. And the production number for this is 352. But yeah, the front end, this one actually has confetti on it. So we actually have an Alex Bowman diecast with confetti on it. So yeah, the entire front of the windshield on the driver's side is completely kicked in confetti. Along with most of the hood. So yeah, nice looking diecast here. You got a little bit of some race marks here. A little bit of burnt, a little tire rub in there from all the beating and banging with it being Martinsville on a short track. Also pretty cool that we're getting this diecast still with Martinsville coming up this weekend. And you can see that side. That side's completely rubbed off. But that Goodyear still has its lettering on it. And a few marks right there. You know, pretty clean for a short track car nonetheless. Like most of the marks though. And the front end of that's actually pretty clean for the most part. I'm surprised they don't have the little like paint of the dented front end in after Hamlin came in. But yeah, Alex Bowman, this was when he won Martinsville and got his fourth win of the season. A win that would have put Alex Bowman in the final four had he made it that far. So yeah, and it was also a pretty cool moment to see the 48 win at Martinsville again. Since it hadn't happened since Jimmy Johnson in 2016. But yeah, still, nice looking diecast here to add to the collection. The first Alex Bowman one of 2021 actually has confetti on it. So yeah, that's pretty cool right there. So yeah, nice car to add to the collection. So now on to our second diecast. And as you see here, they actually taped it up so I just can't just pull it off like this. So for this one, we're going to need to bust out the knife for this Noah Gregson one. They made sure it's taken very good care of. So slice number one. And slice number two. Knife to the side. And now let's open it up. Oh, wait a second. I got the wrong one. This is not the one. That was the Larson one. I do not want to open that one yet. There it is. Here is the Gregson one. I fucked up there. My bad. I didn't want to open up the Larson one just yet. Now, there we go. Now I got the right one. There it is. This is the right one I wanted. The Gregson one right there. And trash that goes. So there it is. The Noah Gregson Martinsville Race Win Diecast. The win that put Gregson in the final four last year. So now let's open it up and take a look. Alright, that's everything out of there. So, of course, this and this, we don't need these. So, in the trash that goes, we got the winner sticker right here. Put that box aside. Here's the hero card for this win right here from Noah Griggs' Martinsville win. And then everything you need to know about it on the back here for the race. Where Gregson wanted a photo finish over Cindric by 64/100ths of a second. And also right here we got this certificate of authenticity because when I'm about to unveil it, voila. You can see it is an autographed diecast. See how we got another Noah Gregson autograph. This is number one. The production number is 106, and they made 552 of these. So there's a pretty good amount of these out there. So yeah, really cool looking car here. You know, they got the back tires completely burned out from his burnout. You know, they got a couple tire marks right here from the beating and banging, and then the marks there from the burnout. And then all that right here. You know, just normal stuff you'd see on a short track. A little bit of a beer end beating in. But, yeah, still a nice-looking car nonetheless. Yep, nice good-looking car here. A win, you know, this win, of course, was a favorite Gregson win of mine. You know, putting Gregson in the final four last year. Too bad he couldn't win the championship last year. But, of course, this year he's in the final four again. And hopefully this time he gets that championship that's alluded to in Xfinity. Maybe this time. But yeah, still, nice looking car here. So yeah, another autographed Noah Gregson diecast. So all three of the Gregson race win diecast from 2021 that I have are all autographed. So yeah, nice little autograph to add to the collection here. Another nice Gregson one too. So far, the only Xfinity diecasts I have, and they're all Gregsons. Not bad. Alright, now with the other two diecasts out of the way, now it's time to unbox the Kyle Larson Phoenix Racewind diecast unboxing. Of course, I had that head start there because I accidentally opened this one up instead of the Gregson one. So now let's just pop it open. Now let's take a look at it. So there we go. And there it is, the Larson Phoenix Racewind diecast. And the hood's kind of opened up there, so I'll have to make sure to shut that hood after. So there's 2,712 of these produced. So there are some that are definitely out there. You'll definitely find one out there. But let's open it up and let's take a look at open, damn it. And the hood just shut, okay. That was kind of weird why the hood was open there. But it should, and it still looks in good condition. But yeah, we don't need these. There's the winner sticker right there. Put that to the side with the other stickers. And here's the hero card here at Larson's championship win. And then everything you need to know about Larson's win at Phoenix last year that got him the 2021 championship. His 10th win of the season that led to the title. And now, it is time to unveil the diecast. Voila! So, of course, there's the diecast. The entire front of the windshield is entirely cut, caked in confetti. So we have a race win diecast that's caked in confetti, unlike Chase Elliott's last year. You know, still, pretty clean car on the rear on this side. Well, clean rear end, like the confetti goes almost all the way to the rear windshield. Like, you can't even see anything out of this. And by the way, the production number for this is 2016. And then you got the entire rear end, where the entire rear end is completely taken out from that long burnout. When Larson tried to do that whole one lap burnout around the entire track, and the rear end just gave out like halfway down the backstretch. And Larson almost took the flag away with him and ended up dropping the flag. Which, honestly, dropping the flag is a goddamn sin. The real disappointing part about this tire isn't chewed up to shit. Like, all they did was just flat spot the tire. That's kind of disappointing. That's kind of disappointing. Like, Lionel's been real fucking lazy with this shit. Like, I'm sad that this tire isn't chewed up. Like, it honestly should have been chewed up, especially after Larson got the flat tire after the rear quarter panel took the tire out. My dad's kind of disappointed that his flat spot. I'm like, Lionel needs to get their shit together on that part. But yeah, still, other than that, it's been very clean for the most part. At least they put a good amount of detail in for the quarter panel getting chewed up. And you can see all the rubber and tire marks there from when the tire got completely cut. But yeah, still a clean looking car here. And then look at the side here. All those race winner stickers. But yeah, this year we've learned that seasons like Kyle Larson's last year don't happen often. I mean, it's very rare in this day and age, but how competitive that how much parity there is in the Cup Series to see a driver win 10 races in a season. Like, it's very rare to see it happen. Like, since the turn of millennium, it's only happened twice. Larson last year and Jimmy Johnson in 07. But yeah, still, a nice, clean-looking car nonetheless. But yeah, nice-looking car here. And they actually added a bunch of associate sponsors on the back deck lid here, if you can see. So yeah, still, nice looking car here. And since we got the Champions diecast here, there's also another package I have here, if you noticed it with the Chase Elliott thing I did with the Chase Elliott one last year. Because this car is not going on the shelf. It's going in a special case like I put the Chase Elliott Phoenix Raceway diecast in. And this case is in this box here. So we're going to do another unboxing where we're going to unbox this bad boy here. And this one, I have not even touched it or opened it, so I have no idea what it looks like. But let's open it up and find out right now. And come on, get in there. So we're gonna slice that open. There we go. And here we are. Let's see if I can pull it out here. Oh, this is gonna be a pain in the ass. Come on, get out. Oh man, that looks so cool. Throw that to the side, and that to the side. So yeah, this is the lid of the box of Kyle Larson for the Kyle Larson diecast. I believe you can use this case for any diecast you want, but I chose to use it for the Phoenix race win. So the Phoenix race win diecast will sit in here for all eternity for storage. And yeah, here is the stand for it too. So when you close it up, it looks like that. So now that we got the stand, all we're missing is the car inside. So I'm going to pull some magic trick and we'll have this car in the box in 3, 2, boom. Just like that, the diecast is now in the case where it rightfully belongs. A nice place to put this beautiful diecast car. So yeah, the diecast, I'm going to put this diecast right beside the Chase Elliott one on the shelf. So yeah, it will sit right beside the Chase Elliott one for years to come. And at least in this case, it won't collect as much dust. It'll actually stay clean for the most part. Since any dust that comes on it will go on the case instead. But yeah, nice looking case, nice looking diecast. A good way to end. So yeah, that's 9 out of 10 diecasts I got from Larson this year. The only one I'm missing is the Charlotte Roval one. That's the only one I'm missing so far. Like, I believe it did ship, but I haven't got it in yet. So if it doesn't come in, I'll probably order a new one and have it come in. But when it does come in, I'll have the unboxing ready to go. But yeah, still, another nice diecast to add to the collection. But yeah, that'll wrap it up here for this unboxing. That's all I'm going to say. And I hope everyone enjoys it. I'll see you all whenever I make next. Peace. NASCAR Heavyweight Champ is out.